Could we have an interview? As you relax back, I want you to imagine you're the most wonderful speaker, praised for your honesty, your directness, your openness, your warmth, and the enormous pleasure people get from hearing you. You are known for your ability to reach and speak to everyone. Young or old, everyone feels you're really talking to them. You are your wise child. It's morning, and you've just woken. Today, you're going to be interviewed live on a major television network. You'll be subjected to a probing interview by one of the most controversial broadcasters on national television. 10 million people will be watching and listening to everything you say, live as you say it. You slept well. You're excited at the opportunity to talk from the heart about something that really matters to you. You're feeling a wonderful flow of energy through your body. You're glad it's there, ready to be used. You need this movement of energy for what you're going to be doing today. Today, you will be a mover of energy. You feel in harmony with yourself and what you're going to do. You are totally focused on talking about what really matters to you. Open to discussing the fear and anger expressed by the interviewer on behalf of the viewers and moving them towards a place of harmony within themselves, changing the way they feel and think for the sake of the greater good. You have been chosen to speak on behalf of others whose voices need to be heard. You are speaking for them. You are their voice. Their energy is passing through you, helping to give you the power you need to help them back into harmony. No longer does your child feel afraid. They're excited. They know they'll be there, helping you to speak to the child inside each and every person who'll be watching and listening. They'll be there with you, listening to the audience, making sure that every thought you express is understood, allowing you to feel safe in the knowledge that you will be truly heard. You wash and dress in your usual way, but with an extra feeling of well-being. You very gently start to hum, moving the sound around your body. All the preparation you've done is there in the sound you are making. You feel your power. You feel your energy in the form of sound. You continue to work through your vocal exercises, very relaxed, very easy. You've done them many times before. You'll do them many times again. They're now part of your daily routine of moving your energy through your body, of bringing you back into harmony. You enjoy the sounds you are making. Hearing your sound focuses you on your ability to hear the needs in others and to respond. You have your usual breakfast, just enough to take away your hunger pains, but not so much that the blood goes to your stomach. You don't have an extra cup of coffee. You don't need your energy moving any faster. You give yourself the time and space to go through each major point of your story's structure and your triggers. You feel confident, knowing your breathing and your mouth are working perfectly, ready to support you as you begin to talk to the person interviewing you. Your journey to the studio is gentle and easy. You arrive at the reception in good time. You're friendly to the people who greet you, even if they seem tense or detached. Their energy feels confused and they send out messy vibes, but today you are so focused that your energy moves towards and through them, shifting them into a place of harmony that they're not used to. Your child feels a momentary fear as the adrenaline starts to flow through your body, but you knew it was coming. You've been waiting for it to happen. And you place your hand on your tummy to calm and reassure your child. All is well. You no longer have any secrets to hide. You are both safe. No one can hurt you. Your child's fears turn into pleasure and excitement. All is well. Occasionally, you hum very quietly under your breath, staying in tune, rebalancing your energy. Someone comes and takes you to a room nearer the studio. As you walk, they explain what's going to happen. They go through with you what the subject of the interview will be and what you're likely to be asked. Their energy passes through you. You also feel the energy of those you pass. You ride their waves of energy as you listen to what you're being told. You're taken into a room and told someone will come for you in a few minutes before you go on air. You take a moment to return to your safe space, to remember again who you really are, to center your energy. You and your child take a moment to remember what you hope to achieve together. You have been interviewed before, and you will be interviewed again. You know what you want to say, what you really want to say. You know that by speaking openly and honestly to the person interviewing you, as if they were your best friend, you will help them and the viewers to understand the world we live in a little more. You will help to release their fears, release the energy that's blocked inside them. You will express your energy and help to bring them nearer to their state of harmony and equilibrium. You will shift their energy by the power of your voice. The energy in the studio and in the people's homes will be moved from fear and anger into a state of harmony as you help them to release their fears for the future. You continue to hum gently. An assistant comes and finds you, telling you they'll take you into the studio when they go into the pre-recorded item. You pause and wait calmly, keeping in touch with your energy. You wish yourself well as you move towards the studio. You're called into the studio. You feel the heat of the lights, You can feel the tension of a live program going out all over the country. You continue to breathe easily as you're shown to your chair near the interviewer. A sound person puts a microphone on you, connecting your voice to the people you're going to talk to. The adrenaline in the studio is immense. You get used to all the lights and all the attention. The interviewer smiles and greets you. They're affable but guarded, preparing themselves for what's to come. You can hear and feel their energy. You can hear and feel their child. They want to bring out what is important in what you have to say. You can feel the enormous pressure they're under to do their job well. You understand their needs, and you respond with a smile and a hello. You listen and watch everything that's happening. You and your child are excited by the energy. You have no fear. The interviewer says he will start with a particular question to introduce the subject. You're told they'll be coming to you in 30 seconds. The moment has come, and you're being introduced. Your energy is moving even faster, ready to be used. Your hands rest on your tummy as you connect again to that other part of you, ready for you both to speak. The wave of energy you know and love is lifting you up as the red light on your camera comes on. The eye of the camera is not cold. On the other side of the lens are the people you want and need to reach. The lens connects you to them. The microphone connects you to them. All eyes and ears are focused on you. All the children are focused on you. You breathe in their energy and begin your conversation. The interviewer asks the first question. Their energy is very powerful. They're louder and more forceful than they were when they said hello. You allow your energy to respond. You listen carefully to what they're asking you, connecting their words to what you want to say. You look into their eyes as you would a dear friend and gently begin your reply. You talk as if to a girl of 13, someone who is very intelligent but not yet worldly. You won't assume she'll understand. You'll check whether she's following your words. It will be a perfect conversation. You feel the responsibility you've been given, but no burden. The child in each and every person watching at home is hearing you talking to them and them alone. Everything feels as though it's in slow motion, as you breathe between each thought. Each thing you say touches you again as if for the first time. You listen to what you just said at the same moment as the interviewer and the viewer. It touches you as it touches them. All of you are in the same moment, sharing the same feelings. You become one being, expressing feelings and emotions that you all share, joined by a web of interconnected energy. They know you are really talking to them, and nothing else matters. The ritual exchange of words and emotions between one human being and another is being re-experienced again several million times. Whatever emotions you feel about what you really want to say will be expressed as you feel them. Nothing will be imposed. Nothing will be faked. This is what you feel now. Whether it be anger, frustration, or fears for the future, all will be expressed. The perfect conversation continues as the interviewer asks you a probing question. You hear the pain they're expressing. You don't ignore it, but breathe as you allow you and your child to find the answer. You answer as honestly as you can, just as you would if a frightened child were sitting there, while remaining clear and focused on what you want to say. You remember, too, the 13-year-old girl who needs to hear and understand your answer. There is no hurry as you explain what you want to say. Now, the interview is over. As the interviewer thanks you, you know you have been heard. You know you shared with the interviewer and the viewers the energy you all felt as you moved them towards a state of well-being. The viewers were just as much a part of the conversation as you were. It was shared by you all. You know you've made a difference. The exchange and transformation of energy has been fulfilled. You have brought everyone closer to their natural state of harmony and helped them to move nearer to their place in this world. The more you do the relaxation and the imaginations, the more your life will be transformed. May your energy flow.